Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Let's Design SimCity 4. My name is Rick Dolster, and we are back at River Crossing, where we're taking a look at the industrial train rail yard thing that we did in the previous episode, which is looking quite good. I wasn't able to play off camera like I said I would with these props. I still kind of like how they look, not at this some level, for example, where the shadows kind of disappear. But at this some level, I think they work quite fine. And in this episode, I'm going to try to finish it. I don't know if we will make it in time because there's so much work that needs to happen here. Hopefully, we can get most of it sorted out. But before I do anything, I want to focus your attention to this stretch of avenue. This is something that I was thinking and someone pointed out in the comment section, which is the fact that this avenue's the avenue basically has four consecutive railroad crossings, which it's not, you know, it's not bad. It's not the best. It's not terrible either. But hopefully we can do a bit better than this. What I'm thinking is basically doing an overpass for the avenue, just so that it just goes over all these four railroad tracks. I think we have enough room for it. It might be a really tight fit, but we'll see. I mean, worst case scenario, we can start from up here and go also over this stretch of road. But if we can, I want to squeeze it between this intersection and maybe this one. So let me start by demolishing this little part. In fact, let's demolish this all, because we're not going to need it for now. There we go. I'm also tempted of demolishing the station simply because we're going to be dealing with overpasses. And it happened before when you hover over transit-enabled lots, it will basically crash the game. So that happened to me once before. So just to make sure, I'm going to delete it. I'm going to put it back in after we are done with all this work. Now that we know where the train tracks will happen. If you will. Well, I guess I can't do that. Anyways, I should probably do this from here, maybe? That way I can... Yeah, there we go. Fantastic. Let me show the grid. There we go. And let's go hunting for some overpasses, shall we? Let's see. Road overpasses, avenue overpasses. So we have this, like, default ones that don't really work for what we're trying to do, because it's basically only one lane. But you see the slope kind of fits here. So I know there's another menu that has the actual, wait, can we do, this is RHW Avenue. Let's see, do we have the slopes in here that we could potentially use? We might not have them here. No, all right, they're not here. I never know where to look for these things. Oh, there we go. Fantastic. That was easy enough. Can we rotate you to the way that we need? So it's going to come like that. All right. It's kind of a steep slope, right? But it works. I think it works just fine. Come on. There we go. All right. Fantastic. We cannot drag this road underneath, unfortunately. Unless, let me see, maybe we can squeeze it in one tile closer to this intersection and get away with it. It doesn't seem like that's going to happen. Let me do this like this real quick. You know what? We might be able to, can we do an intersection here? Yes, we can. All right. So yeah, we can totally do this. Let's just go one tile over that way. There we go. We're going to do this. We're going to do this, and then we're going to go do this, and there you go. We have our overpass just the way it was meant. So now we're going to go into the avenue 15 meter pieces, and we're going to need one over rail that is hopefully not diagonal. We're going to do this. We're going to need two street ones like so. In fact, I need to drag rail before I do any of this. And my concern here is that if I put the rail yard, it might not work. Let me see if that's accurate. Large. I don't even know where it was facing towards. I think it was this way. already occupied. By what? What are you talking about? It's not occupied by anything. We might not be in luck here. We might have to do this first and then get the overpasses. Let me bulldoze this real quick. So part of the learning experience. Yep. Oh boy. All right. So this is how it was. Great. Oh, so this streets used to connect to the avenues. So that's no longer going to happen. We can easily get rid of them. So let's be very careful here. Keep this going. Actually, we're going to need to extend train tracks first and then put the overpasses. Oh man, this is going to be tricky. I really don't want the game to crash. Hopefully I don't have to cut all this out in post-production. All right, let's find the avenue. Elevated thingies. All right, so we're going to start with that. Oh man. There we go. Oh, come on. Do it. So close. There we go. All right. Let's grab the avenue over here. Connect it if we can. There we go. Fantastic. And now let's grab the 15 meters. Start over in this corner. Rail. Okay. So one over here, two over there, three over there, and fourth. All right, so the game didn't crash, but my monitor did, which is even more odd. I'm using an Apple monitor, and it just doesn't want to get along with Windows. Well, I'm using like this weird converter that just doesn't want to get along with Windows, and it's just, don't do that. Get a normal PC monitor. It will make your life a lot less complex. So we're gonna rezone this area right here. I did this, the recording stopped. The game was running, but the recording stopped, so I had to run it again. And actually restarted the game just to get that going. I dezoned this two dots so it doesn't like create that texture underneath the train tracks. They don't look very ugly. In this case, we're gonna keep the three consecutive interchanges here. I don't think they do any harm, like it's fine. Looks a bit more normal. So let me rotate the camera a bit and let's zone this little bit right over here. As you can see, I'm leaving a gap here so we can put more of these fences that we were doing before. Oh, by the way, I need to reconnect this little thing. If I can. Train tracks. There we go. Fantastic. And let me grab the gates that were in here, if I'm not mistaken. Scroll down, all the way up to here. Alley, this is the one that carries traffic, so no. I wish it was the other way around, that this one's do actually had the road part. You know, like this little track. That's what I meant to say. Anyways, I was just thinking about something completely different what I was saying that. But we can get this going like this, hopefully. And we get some more detail over on this side, which is always appreciated. And at the same time, I'm going to grab one of the empty ones if I can. Like so. Well, this is... No, that's not kind of what I wanted. There's like an empty one. There we go. Empty space. Fantastic. It's fine if it's like not completely connected to the rail here. Yeah, I wish that I could like get textures for the inner parts. Unfortunately, I can't. So this will have to do for now. It's not too bad anyways, and it will look great once we have development going around it. So let me focus your attention over to this corner, and hopefully we can get some development going here. Someone, actually not just someone, but a few people have been saying that maybe these tiles look like like pedestrian areas and not so much like streets, which it's kind of a good point. It's a really, really good point. I think I might get rid of them. I mean, if they had, like I said, if they had this texture in, it would be perfect because that would make sense, right? But they don't, unfortunately. So I don't know. We'll see about that. I'll leave it for later. In fact, I want to maybe get rid of these here and see what a street would look like. I mean, of course, without that. In fact, we can do this and get one-way road and get our intersections. Same over here. I think a street looks a lot nicer like this. If we do like nice and smooth curves, it could be even better. Fortunately, I'm just destroying half of the city as I do that, but it's okay. It's fine. It's a nice curvy road. I mean, we can also just come like this and do that, but unfortunately we'd have room for fences, which is, it's totally fine. Oh, another thing that we can do potentially is get this going this way. Yeah, that's much better, actually. All right, fantastic. Another thing that we're going to do here, well, we're going to kill this part. Bulldoze, there we go, fantastic. And we are going to grab these things like this. We're going to get a nice little switch connected over there. And let's see, we need this main road to lead somewhere. So we might dezone all this if we can. There we go. Great. Because this is a kind of a big important connector piece. Like I want, this is like, this leads traffic into the city. So I don't want to redo this part. In fact, I might even turn it into three with a network winding mod, which actually might not be a terrible idea. Let's actually do that. I'm not sure how I'm going to make it work over here, but it wouldn't hurt. Yeah, let's do that right now, real quick. I think I need a starter piece, or no. Yeah, I need a starter piece for this. So I think I'm gonna go with this one with a middle turning lane. Or do we want four lanes? We did four lanes on the other side. Let's do this middle turning lane because, like, usually in places where there's a bit of traffic, especially freight traffic, they use this to park trucks in the middle, at least in the US. I haven't seen this anywhere else in the world. I mean, probably in Canada. I haven't been to Canada. Also, I haven't been to many countries. But what I do know is that people use this thing here in the US for freight. All right, so we have that going. We might need to manually add some turning lanes here and there, which wouldn't be so hard. Let's, I did not want to do that. Now I'm just demolishing things for no good reason, which I guess is fine. There we go, we keep that in. This doesn't work like that, so we're gonna grab you again. So it was just testing to see if we could get away with automatic turning lanes, but no, we have to manually do everything, which is fine, I guess. It just takes slightly more time. Transitions, curves. We might want to transition to two lanes somewhere around here, because it makes sense. Let's see. Where the so curves, we don't need curves, railroad puzzle pieces. I think we need these bad boys. Not sure. There's one that I think is this one what I want. I'm never sure what I need. Some cool stuff in here. So we can put not that. We could potentially put this one here and here and here and here. These needs a turning lane on this side, so let's hunt for that. I saw that in the beginning, so it shouldn't be too hard to spot. Let me do it in a place where I can see what I'm doing. Slip lanes, I don't think we need that. Maybe we can do... Yeah, this is not right. You see, this is not right, the right piece, unfortunately. This is what I wanted. Over here and over there. Great. I wish these textures would like be better, but they are not. So we can do that. Do that. Let me check that this looks nice. Yep, that looks fan-freaking-tastic. Unfortunately, I cannot do it do them inside of the tunnel. So it's a bit odd, I know, but yeah. All these intersections, I don't know, I might leave them as they are. So we're gonna do this over here. Oh, this goes over the top. Oh yeah, this is just gonna be one big mess, unfortunately. It's quite an interesting mess. Yeah, I might end up removing all these tiles. They look cool, or they used to look cool. Now I'm having second thoughts about it. But I'm just jumping all over the place here. Let me continue this layout first. And then I'll fix all these little details. Another thing that I wanted to get in place here is... we need like a main road here that it can end over there. I think that is acceptable. I have a bunch of warehouses that will look fan-freaking-tastic here. Look at this. It's just beautiful warehouses. If there is such a thing, right? We have various sizes too. So this one is 3x5, I think. All right, let's find a good home for this bad boy. Could be here. And it shares sort of the same design and patterns that we had before. So that works great to our advantage. Let's find another one. Well, this one has rail. And I mean, it will be awesome if I can get this to curve over here, but we still run into the issue that this line ends there. Like it wants to continue. It doesn't just end, that's what I'm saying. So that one is not gonna happen. We have another medium one. Let's see, can we put it somewhere else? Maybe somewhere here? Just to mix it up with our current industrial area. It adds a bit more diversity to buildings. And now that we're at it, let's just put this big one. Let's put it over there. Did I not do this one already? No, that's different. All right, fantastic. So we have that in place. Let me grab some smaller roads. Can we intersect you over there? Yeah, but I don't think I want to. We cannot go through that. That's fine. This area right here might need some diagonal work because it's a bit too far away from the from this road. So we can zone some factories over here. I think that will be beneficial. Let me see. I can do that. This could be high density, why not? This whole area will be high density as well. This fence now, it's kind of pointless. Because this complex kind of starts... I mean, now fences don't make that much sense at all in general. Maybe we can get rid of these and have it come this way. You find the little corner piece, like so. So now, yeah, basically fences are part of this whole area and they just end there. I wish that I could do this, but nope. This could overhang more. And also I'm not sure why only these are like with wood, because I would like to have all that if I could, but unfortunately I can't. And now we can easily get rid of this. Yeah, let's do that. Oh, I got rid of the curve. I did not want to do that. Let me dezone this. You know how it is with me. I need to, when I don't like something, I just, it's okay. It's okay to like redo parts of your town. In fact, I'm thinking about another part of town that I want to redo. If we finish this in this episode, then the next episode will definitely involve redoing the small commercial center that we did in the first few episodes. I'll show it to you at the end of this episode what I mean. If we have the time. Is this only 4 roads or 4 avenues? I never remember. Yeah, it is. Great. So we want the 45 degree angle curve. Oh, I had it for a second. There we go. Great. All right, so this is looking a lot more organic and friendly. I kind of want to have this warehouse be horizontal to this. But this switch here bothers me slightly, so maybe we can remove it and move it closer to this area. Let's see, this one was the large warehouse? No, it was the medium warehouse. Great. Can we not fit it here? We could potentially fit it here, but might have to demolish some of that. We can put it here actually and get rid of this road. That way everything will fit nicely. Fortunately, we cannot go over this because there's a transition here. But maybe we can put the transition, wow. We can put the transition closer to this road. Something along those lines, and now we can easily go over, and we can also do that and do that. And I think this works fantastically well because now we can put the diagonal parking here if the terrain is not too, god damn it, you never you hate this parking things game, you really do. For some reason, I don't know why, but you do hate them. What is this? I never use this. Is this like a hotel? Oh, this is a station. That's odd. Never used that. Bri-Pizza multipurpose station with parking. All right. Good for you, Bri-Pizza. If that's even your real name. I do want some more. Maybe 1x1 parking. Is there a 2x1? There is. All right, so we have a mini parking plaza here, which works quite well. The textures almost match, so that's also really good. And now that we have that going, we could potentially go do this and mirror this design. Did I mirror that properly? Oh, this is like one of those things that doesn't want. Oh, I think that's about right. No, this is a bit shorter. I think we want to continue one more tile and do this. Now curve. All right, now it's mirrored. Fantastic. Let's zone some high density in the middle, as we did before. Let's zone some medium density on the outside of it, just like so. This whole area is going to be high density, hopefully. This back area right here might not get a lot of love from this industrial part, so let me get some, I want to get the cross section, intersection, straight section. Is this the one that has, yeah. All right, so we're going to go like this. I don't think traffic will drive through here, unfortunately, but we can have a make-believe road type dealio. Did I not select the right one? I went to corner, curve, there we go. Like so. And I want another straight line. And I want a dead end now. End section. Fantastic, so over here we can do another one of these empty ones. And maybe have a couple more props. It's also interesting how it like they kind of mixes up with these with this warehouse too, which is also good. Oh, and oh, this is transit enabled, I think. That's interesting. Can I not do this? No. That's fine. That is fine. This is mostly aesthetics. I'm not looking for super detailed things. We have a double fence here. We could easily not do that and have... Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I see how it is. It has a double entrance. So maybe we can indeed... Can I not drag road underneath this? Man, that sucks. That would have been so much better. Maybe I can get a road to do this. Or just simply that. That will work as well. Let's put up the empty tiles. I'm sorry, not the empty tiles. It's the gate, the straight alley ones. Already occupied? What? You're supposed to be like that. Are you not? Oh, because you want to be like a normal road, I think. Are we sure that that's what you want? Man, this is confusing sometimes. There we go. Let's grab these alleys. Yeah, you wanted it like that. All right, that's fine. I am okay with that. Unfortunately, the fence is like no longer, it's like open. I mean, it's open in many places, so it doesn't really matter, but it looks kind of cool. Yeah, I'm keeping that. All right, so high density over there. And over in this little empty plot, let's grab the empty space. And we can put some props in it. Hopefully we'll have better luck than previous times. We were doing this drums dealio. Let's just keep this colorful drums instead of the blue ones for now. I don't know. There we go. That looks great. I'm happy with that. Fantastic. We need to get some intersections here. Let's fix that right now before I forget. Let's do that. I think we're gonna need one over yonder. There we go. Let's grab this straight line piece. Already occupied? What are you talking about? There we go. Now it's already occupied. Your face is already occupied. High density, fantastic. Let's grab medium density over here. Nope, this was also high density. Do not mind me. You can continue to pollute this environment factories, that's fine. I do not have a problem with that. Medium density over here. Yeah, this little things won't be able to. I won't be able to zone them, unfortunately, but I think we're in good shape. We might even be ready to start the simulation. Man, I really want to get like some curves on these edges, even though I want like to keep this props dealio thing going. But I do need some curved fences here so that you can easily tell that this is like the end of the, or the beginning of the rail yard lot. Just, it will make a bit more sense. There we go, fantastic. Well, I don't think we can do any props in it, so I won't really bother with them. And I think we might be ready to begin the simulation. Let's see, what can we fit? Somehow one of these diagonal parking thingies here. Actually, we can do one of the curve fillers, but that's more like residential friendly, so maybe not. We can do this, bring it closer to the curve. So now we're gonna put some retaining walls over here. And what about over on this side? We could have some more industrial zones in here. Let me see the zoning that we have for this area. this might be... What is this? Latin Valley, Port of Water... That's not exactly what I needed. Work and freight. I want to know what, like, there's like no difference between yellows, man. Like, if I do this... Yeah, it was medium density. Okay. I wish you would tell me more clearly what you are, but you don't. Oh, in fact, we can dezone this whole area and just have a street come this way. Let me hide this window so it doesn't get in the way. Medium density, there we go. Not too bad, not too bad. All off. So we'll take a second to switch. Because there's like a lot of calculations happening in the back. All right, so now that we have this in place, I think it's a good time for us to start the simulation. But before we do that, we're gonna do a quick save. So in the meantime, you can take a look at what we created so far. I think we're in good shape now, and this is going to provide a lot of work for a lot of Sims. And at the same time, yeah, this part, we still need to figure out some things in here. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten about that. But let's go full speed and see how things develop. Hopefully we'll start seeing some trains getting their cargo into our new rail yard. There is some train action going on here. Of course, we don't have a secondary rail yard situation or freight trains, so I doubt we will see. Well, we get some passenger trains into it. Oh, there you go. And then they die at the end. Fantastic, I love it. I really need to change the skins of these trains. Another thing that some of you commented is that, oh, these trains cannot go this way. Yeah, unfortunately, there's really, like, in order for me to get a... three-way intersection here, I need like basically this whole area. I need to like terraform the entire river, and I don't want to do that. So it's gonna stay like that for a little while. Yeah, that's kind of unfortunate. I mean, the other option would be to kill this bridge and have it go this way, but then we have to, that will complicate things a lot more. And this is not that even a big rail yard. This is just like a minor industrial area. So I'm not gonna worry too much about it for now. So let me add some more of these turning lines. Let me hit play so that the game doesn't run at full speed when I don't really need it to run at full speed. We're gonna put that in. 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 There might be a way to get these textures to match my current texture, sandstone texture. I think Hal Jackie. I mean, I know Hal Jackie had this on his city, and I don't know. I don't remember if his turning lanes looked like different. So I might go check out his old videos and. Potentially ask him. If you're watching Hal Jackie, you can leave it in the comments. That will be really, really appreciated. I know he has commented on a couple of videos before, so maybe he's still watching, and hopefully he can clarify that for me and for all of us, for that matter. Let's go do some retaining walls, shall we? Where were they? I think they were under in the power menu. Yeah, here they are. Fan-freaking-tastic. I'm gonna leave that spot for a staircase. Or just stairs, not staircase. Let's see, we're gonna do... we're probably gonna do the same over here for you, so I'm gonna leave that gap over there. For some stairs, we're gonna add more of these. Oh, now we play the rotating game. Over here, we're gonna have stairs on both sides, so that would be kind of cool. I might end it right here. Let's grab you. and you. Let me rotate the camera to see what I'm doing. And it's gonna end over here, I'm assuming. We could potentially have retaining walls all over this area, which might not be a terrible idea. Let me see if I can get away with it in a nice fashion. Let me start with this little part. There we go. And let me get this bad boys going like so. And we can end it there. No problem. No problem at all. We can do this, this, and this. Fantastic. We can do that. We can do that. We can do... Oh, we have an upside down thing here. You guys didn't tell me about it. I'm sure that you were yelling at the screen. You messed that up, man. Fix it. That's what I usually do with other YouTubers. This could be better suited for... Oh, what's happening? Oh, I thought the game was gonna crash. Now that we're at it, let's just put the stairs in. Do the same over here. There we go, great. Let me grab the little thingy. Like so. All right, so this is looking good. This is looking very, very good. We're gonna need one of the ends. Right end, is this the end that we need? This is the end, my friend, this is the end. I think that kind of works well, so I'm gonna keep that. We could potentially zone more industrially over here. That would be quite nice, if you ask me. So let's go ahead and do it. Why not, right? Do that over there as well. We could also put some bus stops. That I haven't done any of that. I need to work on that, because I keep forgetting. Micromanaging, man. It's hard. It's really hard. Right end, is this what we want? Yep. This is a corner piece, and this is left end, so that's not what we want. This could be what we want. Yep, fantastic. All right, so we want the left end now for this little thing. For this little thing, we're done here, so that's good. And we want the little dealio over there. All right, so we have some retaining walls all over this area, which is very, very good. I'm going to put some ashes in here. Just to spice things up. And we're gonna do some chestnuts, of course, for volume. Can we put some chestnuts in here? Nope. But we could potentially put a bunch over here just to protect the rail from interfering with our industrial area. Not that it will happen, but yeah, we can have some nice little trees all around this area. Even on top of our tunnel here. Getting some more trees over in this part. Not a lot, just the right amount to get some volume and detail and separation between things. Something simple like that. All right, great. Things are looking very, very good so far. We could put a bunch over here as well. Just to mix it up. Let's grab some ashes as well. Man, I love those ashes. We could keep this beachfront clean. Everything doesn't have to have trees or rocks or things. And we have quite a bit of development. Oh, we have some areas here that we can zone. Or no. No. Forgot about that. Let's grab some more trees then. It's a nice forested industrial area. We can have some industry here. Let's do this first, then do that, and then do this. So it's a bit more, you know, organic and not just too boxy. Something like that. Let's grab some more of these beautiful chestnuts. Cover some of these pieces. When the stones start growing, they will delete some of these trees. That's why I'm like putting them over. Some more of these ashes. All right, that is very, very good. And we could do something with this. I'm not sure. Like some of you have been suggesting that I should do like a proper like port with container ships and things like that. Honestly, this type of I wouldn't do that in a river. And I would like to have a more like a bigger industrial area for that with a ton more warehouses. I feel like that's more of a like an open like ocean or sea port type dealio. So I'm gonna keep things simple. We're gonna get to that in a different city plot, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. But for the time being, I want to keep this city as simple as possible. Let me speed things up so that we can get some growth on this zones. Hopefully this one wouldn't give me a no car area. It seems like it's a bit farther away from the road. If that's the case, I might plop something in there. Not sure what. I'm not sure what. Yeah, this might not grow. I'll think about that in our next episode. Or we can do something cool. We can put a small park and reduce pollution. Is there one of these parks that actually looks semi-industrial? I don't think I have anything like that. Filler plaza, no. Filler with trees. We can put a filler with trees. Why not? There we go. That looks nice. That is a really polluting factory with like some nice trees around it. That's just how I would like to see all the industrial areas in the world. How I like them to look like, I guess. But I think we did good in this episode. So in the next one, this is what I'm thinking of. Let me hit play. So first of all, this is what it looks like. So you can take a look. In the next one, what I'm thinking of doing is redesigning this part, because it just like there's like a curve and there's like so much emptiness in between these buildings. It just doesn't look right. It does not look right with a winding mod. I kind of want to redo this whole little part. So I might remove one of the farms. I might relocate the train station. I'm not sure. This is the first thing that we did when we started this series. So I want to come back to this and do a bit of work there, and hopefully we can start slowly moving on to this part of town. I'm not sure that I want to keep this avenue like this. A lot of you have been suggesting that they want like a couple more small towns and then everything just be like forests and like trail paths. I kind of like that idea of having like a forest with like little trail paths in between, so I might do that, to be honest. I think it will be a nice nice thing. We can someone also suggested something that I got me thinking, like do like a big next to the city, but I think we can do it over here, do like a Walmart kind of like big department store type dealio, like a big with like lots of parking and like really warehouse kind of block of cement looking mall. So I might hunt for some of those mods, and if I can get a decent one, we can start working on this area or in this area. I mean, eventually we're gonna work in every single part of the town, but there's also a lot of work that needs to be done over in this corner. This maze of tunnels, not my cup of tea, and obviously not the case for also most of you. So we're gonna root through this. This is not properly done. We will come to this and we'll fix it. So yeah, that's what you should do with everything. So yeah, I think I'm going to put an end to this episode right here. So if you enjoyed, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. The button is right underneath this video player or in your tablet or phone, smartphone, whatever it is you're watching this. An action like that is highly, highly appreciated. And also, if you're new to my channel, if you just landed on this video randomly, please don't forget to subscribe if you want to keep, if you enjoy it and if you want to keep watching these videos and get notified every time I post new stuff. And also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter. A lot of people have been getting like little teasers and like the Rollercoaster Tycoon series that I launched a couple days ago was premiered on Twitter. So if you're not following me on Twitter yet, you should go do that. Because I'm not kidding when I say that I post things in advance on Twitter. In fact, there's a couple new things going up on my channel that will be up in the next couple weeks and next month. And if you're not following me on Twitter, you will be late to the party. So that being said, I want to thank you guys for watching, and I really hope to see you in the next one. Have a good one.